Okay, prove that in two concentric circles, the chord of larger circle which touches the smaller circle is bisected at the point of contact. Okay, so there are two concentric circles. What are concentric circles? The center should be same. Okay, suppose this is one circle and the center is this. And let us draw a bigger circle with the same center. Okay. Let us say these are two circles, two concentric circles. Let the center be O. Alright. Now, the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle. That means, so chord to the big circle, let this be A, B. A, B is chord to the bigger circle, right? And this chord is just touching the smaller circle. Let P be point of contact. P is point of contact. That means AB is tangent to the smaller circle, isn't it? Okay. Now, if we join this, OA will be equal to OB. Because OA is the radius of the big circle, right? And OB is the radius of the big circle. And if we drop a perpendicular here, okay? So a triangle OAP is formed, right? So in triangle OAP and one more triangle OPB is formed. So this is O, P and B. See here, OA, this two, OA and OB, two sides are equal. This OA and OB, two sides are equal, right? And OP is common. OP is common side. All right. And this is the radius and this is the tangent, right? So we have learned that radius and tangent will be perpendicular to each other. So this angle P is 90 degrees, right? So by RHS, okay. What is RHS congruency? By RHS congruency, what is RHS congruency? Right angle hypotenuse side. See? In a right angle triangle, if hypotenuse sides are equal, see here we have two right angle triangles, okay, hypotenuse sides are equal and any one of the sides is equal. So here OP and OP both are equal, right? That means the third side will also be equal and the two triangles are congruent triangles, right? So that means AP is equal to PB, right? So which is AP is equal to PB. Okay, we needed to prove that only, isn't it? AP is equal to PB, that means point P is the midpoint. Okay, that means point P is bisecting this chord, right? See here, the chord of the larger circle which touches the smaller circle is bisected at the point of contact. So point P, so this implies P is midpoint of AB. P is midpoint of AB, which means P is AB is bisected at P, point of contact. All right.